What goes on behind the cockpit door? Hi, it's Frank the pilot. With amazing revelations of what a professional pilot sees, thinks, and feels, I want to share my knowledge and experience with you by revealing the tricks of the trade, or what pilots call the gouge. The gouge is valuable information for pilots and non-pilots. Gouge number two from chapter number two, the second flight, which was actually my first flight lesson. This is from the book, Frank the Pilot. The second flight for me was more like the first flight lesson because during that first flight, I was occupied with absorbing the awe-inspiring experience. It was entertainment during that first flight. On this second flight, less than about an hour and a half, I was actually learning how to fly. Sometimes you have to get that wow factor out of your system before you can settle down and actually learn anything. During this flight lesson, we talked about pre-flight. Pilots use checklists during several segments of the flight, such as pre-flight, pre-start, taxi, before takeoff, and cruise. Checklists have been so successful for so many years that today, doctors use checklists for surgery to avoid mistakes. This lesson also included straight and level flight, the use of trim, turns at various degrees of bank angle, climbs and descents, and orientation. The best part of this flight was the landing. The instructor allowed me to put my hands on the controls so that I could feel what he was doing and we can land together, in a manner of speaking, as he walked me through what was happening. Landing is the transition from the plane flying to the point of ground contact. Learning to land an airplane properly is the hardest part of flying. Gouge number two. There's a lot to learn in that first flight lesson, but it's mainly about getting to acquainted with the aircraft procedures and the basic maneuvers. Be sure to study beforehand the lesson plan for that flight lesson. What is a lesson plan? A lesson plan is a detailed outline of what the student needs to learn, how it will be taught, and how learning will be measured. Try to understand the basics before the details and define and memorize important terms. Some things just will not click until you see it in flight. After each flight, take notes, review, and practice chair flying of what you've just learned. What is chair flying? Well, it's like sitting in a chair or simulator and visualize yourself at the controls of the plane and talk through what you've just learned, like manipulating the controls and power during landings. This helps the student hone their memory muscle. Don't worry about how much you have to learn. All students learn at different rates and comprehend certain pilot skills quicker than others. Grab a copy of this bestseller book to follow me as I give you the gouge. Come fly with Frank the Pilot and get an opportunity to see the world from behind the cockpit. From behind the cockpit door, in the cockpit. It's like pulling the curtain up and saying, wow, what's going on? It's a guide to life in the skies. Thank you for those 4-star ratings and book reviews. And thank you for following me on YouTube. I feel good that I can share with you and give back. Enjoy the day, if not the night.